Hey y'all, and welcome back to Mini Homestead and Honey. If you're new here, I'm Christina. I am married to a wonderful Australian man, and I have a teenage daughter. So, yeah, my life is busy. We have some family friends coming over tonight, and she has two young girls, 9 and 10. So, I'm gonna finally make my Berkey video. I promised it was coming. So it's coming. So I use the Ghirardelli that I found at Costco. And I just go by the recipe on the back for one packet. Which is one packet of mix. Or you can use your favorite mix and just make it the way the mix tells you, or your favorite brownie recipe. It is 1/3 cup of oil. I use vegetable oil because that's what it says. A 1/3 cup of water. And one egg. Please bear with me because I usually make a mess when I crack an egg. I've been doing this for many, many years and still don't have a perfect method for it. And then you just mix that up. Sometimes it's a little dry or thick, but you want it to be thick because it's just the way it is. So I hope everyone's had a fantastic week. Our week has, our time has kind of gotten away from us. Being unwell makes everything seem really, really bizarre. And you lose track of time. But I'm very proud of my daughter. She made burgers on her own yesterday with one of her therapists, and she got to have lunch with us, and the burgers were beautiful. So it's a new thing for her. She knows how to cook some things, but trying to get her more confident in the kitchen is okay. So with that, what I do is I grab out my pan, my cookie sheet. I take a little cookie scoop and I just scoop a small, and yeah, it's kind of runny today, I don't know. I think it's very weird. I think that there's a lot of humidity in the air, which will kind of mess with your recipe, so you gotta be easy, and I just dumped it all, so yeah. My fault. So these may not turn out right. But that's okay. We'll start with 6. We'll see what happens. If we need to, we'll add some cocoa powder into it. And got my oven heated and ready to go. And I can tell right now that they're spreading too much. And they're very, very liquidy. So I think we're gonna add some cocoa powder and just try to fix it. So, I promise, I'm not leaving. So in case you haven't, give me a big thumbs up if you like, enjoy my videos, and think about subscribing. Like, I would love to have, and I just made a mess. Are you really, really baking if you're not spreading everything all over the counter? All right. I just did 2, like, oh, and I'm now wearing it, which is lovely. Okay. how that goes. Looks like that's going to thicken it up enough. Awesome. Might need a little bit more, so like just enough, half a teaspoon or a tablespoon. I'm just using a spoon from the cutlery. And that's how it should be. It should be quite thick where it doesn't really run too much. So we're gonna take these and I'm just gonna throw that in the sink. Okay, grab some cooking paper. This is why I use baking paper. Just in case I make a mistake. Because you can just pick it up. And you've got a clean surface to throw new baking or cookies or muffins or whatever it is you're making. All right, let's try again. And I'll know by the first one. Much better. See, they kind of stay more circular than the last ones. The last ones were quite runny. These do have chocolate chips in them, so it gives them an extra special something. And throw those in the oven for probably 10 minutes and see how that goes. So while the brownies cook, or the brownie cookies cook, I'm making buttercream icing. You can do it in a stand mixer, but my daughter's still sleeping, so I'm trying to do it quietly. So I'm doing it by hand. And all it is butter, powdered sugar, and vanilla. I use vanilla paste. It intensifies the vanilla flavor. And so I've been working at it for a while. I'm doing it by hand. And rather than making you watch me do it by hand, it's already done. So it should be about that consistent. You don't want it to be too runny. So you add a little more powdered sugar than you normally would, just so it stays thick. And that way it's easy to keep on the two pieces when you stick them together. It's just beautiful. So, all right, we'll come back in just a second and we'll assemble. So when you pull them from the oven, you want them to be firm to the touch. They're not underbaked at all because you can't have them gooey or they won't hold up. So there's our first six out of the oven.
So now they're cool and I put my buttercream, my vanilla buttercream in a sandwich bag. I'm just gonna cut the tip quite big because I don't want too much. I want to be able to control it a bit, but it just needs to be scooshed in there. All right. So I make them to where, to make the sandwiches, you just find ones that are about the same size, and you scoosh some vanilla cream in there. And I smush them quite heavily. And there you go. There's your beautiful brookie. And I put them on a platter or in an airtight container. You can put them in the fridge. They're really good from the fridge when they're nice and cold, with a big glass of cold milk. My daughter
daughter, she loves these. We had them at one of the cafes, and I was like, I think I can make that. So I came home and I made them. And how pretty do they look on my little tray? It has bees on it. My neighbor bought it for me for Mother's Day last year. Because she's sweet like that. And that's all there is to it. I've got about 100 more brookies to make. So thank you so much for joining me. I am so grateful for anybody who watches my videos. Subscribe, give me a thumbs up so I know I'm doing it right. And yeah, I hope to see you next time. And in case nobody's told you, you're doing a wonderful job at life, at parenting, at whatever's going on in your life right now. So keep up the great work. See you next time.